We will do chapter 2 today, which is called Why You Should Learn Mathematics Well. Now, this is a lovely story set in a village. In a village, there were lots of farmers who used to do their farming every day. They had some animals, and there was also a rich man. Now, this rich man had a big house, lots of animals, lots of fields, but there was one problem with him. All the time, he was thinking of how to make more money, how to become richer. Now, that's not something bad, but it becomes bad when you're willing to cheat to be able to earn more money. And that is what this man used to do. In the objective of becoming richer and making more money, he used to cheat the others. He used to cheat those poor farmers who came to his asking him for money. So whenever those poor farmers used to come to him and ask him for money, he would lend the money, but he would give it at a very high interest. And the farmers were not able to pay the interest, and they were not able to return the money. And this rich man would land up in their house one fine day announcing that that little money that you had taken from me has now compounded and added up with the interest, and it has become a very big amount. Obviously, the poor farmers were not able to pay that big sum of money. And this rich man would then take their animals, or take their piece of land, or take their house, making them even more poor. And they had to again and again come to this rich man asking for more money. Now, he was cheating these farmers. One fine day, what happened? One farmer, his wife became very ill. And he wanted to take his wife to the doctor, but he had no money. So, of course, he went to the rich man. He asked the rich man to buy his cow. Now, this poor farmer was thinking that he will be able to sell his cow for 500 rupees. But this rich man said, I can offer only 25 rupees for your cow. The farmer said, this is a very good cow and it gives lots of milk every day. How can you pay me only 25 rupees for such a good cow? And he said, that's my final offer. I will pay you only 25 rupees, or else you can take your cow and go away from here. The poor farmer had no option. He had to sell his good cow, which used to give so much of milk, which was worth 500 rupees. He had to give away his cow for a small amount of 25 rupees. He took that money and with a heavy heart started walking back home. On the way, he met one girl, one lady who used to stay in that village, Sarla. And Sarla asked the farmer why he was so sad. The farmer explained his entire story to Sarla, telling her that he had bought his cow and was expecting to sell it for 500 rupees. But the rich man paid him only 25 rupees for the cow. Sarla understood the trick that this rich man was playing on all the poor farmers of the village. The farmer went away. Sarla went back home. In her house, she was living with her in-laws because her husband was posted outside the village. She used to take good care of her husband's parents. But she was quite disturbed hearing the farmer's story. She understood that this rich man is cheating all the poor farmers of the village, because she knew mathematics, and she knew that this amount that was taken for loan does not sum up to this kind of interest. She wanted to do something about it. She wanted to help those poor farmers and teach the rich man a lesson. She came up with a plan. What she did is, one day she went to the rich man and she told him that my husband has written a letter to me asking me to take his parents and join him in the city. Now, he has also asked me to sell all the things that we own. So, I have come to you so that you can buy everything that I own, because I do not want to sell it to separate people. The rich man asked her what all it is that she owned. Sarla told him that she has a hen, she has a calf, she has a cow, a bull, a house, and a field that gives very good yield. Gives very good yield means grows a lot of crops per year. The rich man asked her, how much money she was expecting for all these goods. Sarla explained to him that she is going to follow a mathematical sequence with him. Now, this rich man did not know any maths, but he was quite interested. Sarla told him that I will sell you the hen for 2 rupees. The rich man was very happy on hearing this because 2 rupees is very cheap for a hen. She further explained to him that she will sell the calf for 2 multiplied by 2, that is 4 rupees. Now the rich man was getting very happy. He said, this girl is asking for very little money. He wanted to quickly agree that he is going to buy everything. Sarla further explained that she will sell the cow for 4 into 4, that is 16 rupees. So she is taking out the square of the previous amount. The hen is for 2 rupees, so 2 square is 4, that becomes the cost of the calf. 4 square is 16, that becomes the cost of the cow. And 16 square is 256, which becomes the cost of the bull. This is where Sarla stopped. And the rich man was already very happy. He quickly agreed that I will buy everything from you. She said that we will have this agreement in front of the panchayat of the village. Now the panchayat of the village is a group of 5 people who take care that law and order is maintained throughout the village. So the rich man agreed that, okay, I will have this agreement with you in front of the panchayat. So they went in front of the sarpanch and they told all this agreement. The rich man agreed, the panch agreed, and everybody was happy. Now the rich man asked, what is the final amount of money that I have to give? Sarla explained to him that the hen is for 2 rupees, the calf is for 4 rupees, the cow is for 16, the bull is for 256, and the house is for 256 into 256, that is 65,536. Now the rich man was feeling little jittery because this amount is very big for a house in the village. The houses in the village don't cost this much. But he was further listening. She explained that the field will cost him the square of 65,536, which is 429,49,67,296. The rich man could not believe his ears. He had liked the mathematical sequence that she was following, but he was not happy with such a big amount. No field in the village can cost this much. And he explained to the sarpanch that I cannot pay this kind of money. Now the panchayat told him that you have made an agreement and you will have to pay the money to her and you will have to buy those things, otherwise you will be punished. The rich man tried very hard to explain to the panchayat that he does not have this kind of money and he will not be able to buy all this. In this case, Sarla told him that when you go to the house of the poor farmers asking them for the money and they say that we do not have the money, you take away their cattle, you take away their house, you take away their fields. So this is exactly what is going to be done to you. Your cattle will be taken away, your house will be taken away, and all the little plots of field that you own will be taken away. The rich man did not want this, but the panchayat declared that this is what is going to be done. Sarla took all his possessions and returned the fields to those farmers from whom he had taken. That farmer whose wife was ill, he also got his cow back. All the villagers were very happy and the rich man was taught a good lesson. So through this lesson, the author is trying to tell us that it is good to try to earn money. We should do it. That is our final goal. We are coming to school, we'll go to college, we'll get a job so that we can earn money and run our houses. But we should not be willing to earn that money through cheating. We should not be willing to pass our exams through cheating, because at the end you will have to lose it all. Unless you have earned it, unless you have worked hard for it, you are not going to gain. If you are passing your exams through cheating, you have actually not learned that lesson, and that is going to become a heavy penalty as you grow up, when nobody will be teaching you that and you have not learned it in your life. So it is advisable that you should work hard for whatever you want to achieve in life.
No more spending your energy and money on coaching classes or missing classes for rain, for rally, and any other nonsense. Subjects covered by multiple teachers with repeat telecasts. Doubts, concepts, applications, no problem. All explained through great and significant animation. So sit back comfortably in your home and watch Study Spectrum TV channel.
Let us look at the new words that we have come across in this lesson. The first word is announce. Announce means to tell. To tell somebody is to announce something. Second word is intelligent. Intelligent means a clever person, a wise person who is able to think more than others can. The third word is received. Received means got. When you get something from someone, you have received something. The fourth word is a pattern. When Sarala tells the rich man that I am going to ask you to pay for the things in a mathematical pattern, a pattern means a particular sequence. We are going to follow a particular order. So that is a pattern. The village council. The village council is the panchayat, the group of five people who take care of the law and order in that village. That is known as the village council. And the last word is ruined. When the panchayat tell the rich man that everything that he owns is going to be taken away, the rich man says, I am ruined. Ruined means I am destroyed. I am finished. Because now that rich man was going to become a poor man. Now that we have finished with the word meanings of the lesson, let us look at the questions based on the lesson. Now that we have finished looking at the new words in the chapter, let us look at the questions that are based on the lesson. The first question is, how did the rich man trick the farmers? Now we know that the rich man used to trick the farmers, but how? The rich man tricked the farmers by giving them an amount of money as loan, but asking for a very high interest on the loan. And when the farmers were not able to pay the money, the rich man would take away their cattle, their field, and their house. So there are two points to this answer. The second question is, why did Sarala get angry when she heard the old man's story? We will here not only have to say why Sarala got angry, but we will also have to tell the old man's story in brief. So we are going to say, the old man told Sarala that the rich man had bought his cow for only 25 rupees instead of 500 rupees. So Sarala got very angry because she understood mathematics and knew that the rich man has tricked the poor farmer. The last question is, what was Sarla's pattern? Here we will have to explain that Sarla's pattern was that starting from the smallest commodity, that is the hen, and going to the most expensive commodity, that is the field, she would start with hen costing rupees 2, and then next is the calf. The calf would cost the square of the cost of the hen, that is 2 square, which is 4. The next commodity is the cow. Now the cow would cost the square of the cost of the calf. The cost of the calf was 4. So the cost of the cow will be 4 square, that is 16. And the cost of the bull would be 16 square, that is 256. The cost of the house would be 256 square, which is 65,536. And the plot of land would cost 65,536 square, which is 429,49,67,296 rupees. This was Sarla's pattern. This is the end of the literature questions based on the lesson. Let us further look into the language questions based on the chapter. at the literature questions based on the chapter, let us look at the language questions that are based on the lesson. What they are asking here to do is write whether the following are right or wrong. So basically, it's more like a true or false sentences that we do in science. The first sentence is, Sarla's husband had asked her to leave the village immediately. Is it true or false? It is false. Because what they are asking here is, had actually Sarla's husband asked her to leave the village? No. Sarla's husband had not asked her to leave the village. This is the lie that Sarla told to the rich man. So the answer here will be false. The second statement is, the council members tried to help the rich man. Did the council members, did the panchayat try to help the rich man? Did they want him not to lose all his money? No. The panchayat did not try to help the rich man. In fact, they tried to teach him a lesson. So again, the second sentence will also become wrong. The third sentence is, at first, the rich man thought that Sarla was selling off her things very cheap. At first, before he came in front of the panchayat, did the rich man think that Sarla was selling her things for very cheap? Yes, he did. This sentence is correct. Because by then, Sarla had only told him that the cost of the hen would be 2 rupees, the cost of the calf will be 4 rupees, the cost of the cow will be 16 rupees, and the cost of the bull will be 256 rupees. So till then, the rich man thought that Sarla is selling off her things very cheap. So this sentence becomes correct. The last sentence is, the rich man learnt a lesson. Did the rich man learn a lesson? Yes, the rich man learnt a lesson because the panchayat took away all his land, all his cattle, all his money and distributed it among the villagers. Wherein the rich man became a poor man and of course he learnt his lesson. So did the rich man learn a lesson? Yes. So the fourth sentence becomes correct. The next language question based on the chapter is, read the following carefully and explain the difference in their meanings. So they have given us a set of two sentences which are similar to each other, but they have a subtle difference. Let us look at the first example. The first sentence is, the rich man suddenly announced that they owed him a huge amount. And in the same set, the second sentence is, the rich man would suddenly announce that they owed him a huge amount. Now, what is the difference between the meanings of the two sentences? The first sentence, the rich man suddenly announced that they owed him a huge amount, means on a particular day in the past, the rich man had done this. He had suddenly announced that they owed him a lot of money. In the second sentence, the rich man would suddenly announce means that the rich man used to do this on a regular basis. It's not just narrating one incident, but it is telling us about the habit of the rich man that he used to do it on a regular interval. He used to do it again and again. That is the difference in the meaning because of the inclusion of the word would. Let us look at the second set of sentences. The first one is, the poor old man had sold the cow for 25 rupees. The second sentence is, the poor old man had to sell the cow for 25 rupees. Now here, the poor old man had sold the cow is narrating an incident wherein the poor man sold his cow for 25 rupees. But when you say the poor man had to sell his cow, meaning he did not want to sell it, or rather he did not want to sell it for 25 rupees, but he had to sell it. He was under some compulsion and that's why he had to do the action. So the word had to over here is changing the meaning of the sentence to a compulsory action wherein the subject doesn't want to do it but had to do it because of a certain compulsion.